taken any drugs, any hallucinogens?
No. No drugs. No.
Okay.
It's not uncommon when patients come to the ER that they don't want to tell why they're actually there. So sometimes they'll actually make up a reason.
Just tell her you have nothing to be ashamed of.
Eventually, he tells me that he's there because he hasn't been able to urinate all day. That is most commonly from dehydration.
When was the last time that you urinated?
It's been about 8 hours.
Have you been hydrating?
Absolutely. Yep. Me and Oriella hydrate constantly, mentally and physically.
We're big time into juicing.
So at that point, I became a little bit more worried about urinary tract infection. You're worrying about renal failure as well.
I'd like to get a urine sample from you whenever you can provide one.
In renal failure, we look for the creatinine level. It's a lab test on the basic metabolic panel that tells you their kidney function, what we basically look for to distinguish somebody who's having renal failure versus their kidneys are fine.
I'd also like to take some blood from you so that we can make sure that your kidneys are functioning properly. I'm going to have to ask you some very personal questions. You have the option, you can have your wife stay in the room, or I can ask you in private. What would you prefer?
Yeah, she can stay.
When a man comes into the emergency room who's in their 20s or 30s and they're complaining of symptoms that are consistent with a urinary tract infection, the primary concern is, do they have an STD, a sexually transmitted disease, such as chlamydia or gonorrhea?
I'm sorry, can I ask, how would he have gotten a urinary tract infection?
Well, there's a lot of different possibilities, but one possibility is an STD in his age group, such as chlamydia.
Hold up. What did you just say?
The most uncomfortable part of any ER doctor's job is talking to a patient about the possibility of STDs, especially with their partner right there.
Babe, she's wrong.
Okay, so no one's accusing you of anything. Right now, we just need to get the sample so that we can be complete as part of our workup. So what I'll need to do, since you're having a little bit of trouble urinating, is swab the inside of
There's no need.
I cannot believe you.
So now the wife is just in an uproar. She's very angry. She thinks that he cheated on her.
After everything we've been through, tell me who she is. Who is she?
Nobody's ever gonna say, oh yeah, I think I have chlamydia. It doesn't happen.
Doctor, I do not have an STD. There's no way. Oriella's my goddess.
So I came in the room to swab his urethra.
Okay, Sean, I'm here to do the urethral swab, so I'm gonna need you to just lower your pants a little bit for me.
He's probably heard that a lot lately. Oh my God.
The wife and I both looked in a little bit of horror at what we saw.
What did you do?
His penis was swollen, and that's not something that you see that commonly.
Where is that going?
The urethra, which is the hole where, you know, they're going to urinate from, was widened. It was something I've never seen before.
God, serves you right. You met someone in Central America, didn't you?
When the wife brought up a foreign place and the fact that he was there, it did make me wonder, could there be something else going on?
Aurelia, we're gonna ask for you to wait outside.
Once the wife left the room, the patient kind of relaxed a little bit and said to me that he hasn't been totally upfront and that he has some information that he wanted to tell me.
Really? You feel that was a valiant effort?
So now he tells us that his wife has been kind of hard on him lately.
Baby, you were honored.
No, I was not. I was bored.
Which is evident. We can see that she may be the type that's a little hard on him at times.
Man, are you serious?
Embarrassingly enough, he tells us that he has been told by her that he's not adventurous enough in the bedroom.
So I just got this idea that I can unlock my more natural state of being and find my, you know, sexual spirit.
He was out on the hills behind their house that day, naked. He was kind of frolicking around on the hills, enjoying the sunshine and just being with nature is how he told me. And that a legless lizard had kind of slithered over him.
Hey, little guy. What's your name? I'm Sean.
I never had heard of a legless lizard before, though. This was totally new for me.
A whatless what?
A legless lizard. It has ear holes and eyelids, just like a snake. So I was just sitting there in this little thing started to slither up my leg.
And so you're saying it went into your...
Yeah.
He found it awkward that he actually enjoyed the pleasurable sensation. And the next thing he knew, it got scared.
So you're telling me that the lizard went into your...
Yeah.
He went back for x-ray, and sure enough, when the x-ray result came back...
What's going on in there?
There was, in fact, a legless lizard in his bladder. I don't think that I really believed that there was a lizard inside of him until I saw that. Anybody who looked at the x-ray would feel a little shudder just looking at it, because you could see the outline of the body of what looked like a snake coiled up onto itself, as if it was just sitting there on the ground. And now it's a question of, how do we get rid of it?
The urologist, Dr. Bordet, will be coming in any minute. He's going to be explaining the cystoscopy procedure that he's going to do.
So that's where we call our consultant friends, the urologist, to come help us out.
That is going in me?
What they would do in this case is use a special tool called a cystoscope, which is inserted into the urethra where the legless lizard went into.
This procedure is going to require you to go under general anesthesia, and I know how you...
Yes, give it to me.
It has a camera on it, and so it actually is very flexible, and so it allows them to go up into the urethra, into the bladder, where they can look around with the camera.
Are you sure you need the drugs?
Yes. Give me the drugs.
Okay. He was into natural living, but he was certainly happy to take the painkiller when it was offered to him.
The cystoscope actually has a little clasping hand that can actually clasp onto the lizard and pull it directly back out where it went in. They took him to the OR pretty fast and removed the legless lizard from his bladder.
Don't worry. It's all natural.
I saw the patient after his operation.
Don, how are you feeling?
He's doing much better, thank you.
Excellent. Well, as soon as we get you rehydrated and your kidney function returns to normal, you'll be able to go home.
Did it make it, doctor? The lizard?
Oh, Sean, I'm afraid it did not.
He was very disappointed about this, and he just felt awful.
Oh, don't worry, honey. You didn't mean to hurt the lizard.
This couple, they're gonna last.